In today's demo, we'll be building an interactive and immersive role-playing multi-AI agent game with Redpanda Connect. Traditional RPG or role-playing games are celebrated for their rich world filled with NPCs, non-player character, that provides essential information, hints, and contributed to the overall world building. However, many games today fall short in this area, often featuring NPCs with repetitive and robotic dialogues, which can be monotonous. When I saw the potential of LLMs, large language models, in creating meaningful dialogues, I immediately thought, what if we can use those LLMs to enhance NPC interactions, making them more natural and immersive? That is exactly what we'll be exploring today. First, let's consider the architecture. In the gaming world, traffic can be highly unpredictable, so we need a flexible infrastructure that can handle these fluctuation loads while allowing room for future expansion. We're using event-driven architecture with Redpanda serving as the backbone for our data traffic. Redpanda Connect will act as a pipeline, seamlessly interacting with all the components. For our LLM integration, we'll use a locally running Llama models and then an OpenAI service. We'll also build a small portal for this game with a Node.js frontend. As you can see, Redpanda is already installed and running. Here you can view the Redpanda console, where you can manage topics, monitor data streams, and configure security settings. But for today though, we'll focus on the data and the topics. Now that the streaming platform is set up and all topics are created, let's go ahead and build our first pipeline agent. We'll use Redpanda Connect to interact with locally running LLM, in this case, Llama 3.1. The output will then be forwarded to another topic called RPG response. I've also set up a system prompt to guide these responses, ensuring these responses are delivered in the voice of a fantasy world hero, limited to just 5 sentences with an upbeat tone. Great! That's one NPC down. Next, we're going to build another agent pipeline for our second NPC. This time, we're going to use OpenAI. Before we dive in, make sure you obtain an API key from the OpenAI service. Just a heads up, there might be some costs associated with running the service. This pipeline will function similar to the first one. It will take the questions and dialogues sent by the player, forward them to OpenAI for processing, and then send the response back to the designated topic. I've also included a specific system prompt for the character, a powerful sorcerer who excels in light magic, but has a very shy personality. Now that we've built both characters, let's take a closer look into how we've handled all the routings. We've set up the system to intelligently redirect and split the traffic based on specific NPCs. This approach allows us to distribute the load efficiently, extracting the player's question from the payload and routing them to the appropriate LLMs. Each NPC interaction is powered by a different model, making the experience more dynamic. The best part? Redpanda Connect makes configuring this routing process straightforward and decorative. No hassle at all. Next, let's start up all 3 pipelines and then get the front end running. And there it is, everything is up and running smoothly. Now let's go ahead and interact with NPCs and see them in action. As you can see, the NPCs engage with us in personalized, immersive conversations, bringing the game world to life. So, using LLMs for more natural conversation is great, but to truly enhance the world building, we can take it a step further with Retrieval Augmented Generations, or RAG. RAG combines the power of LLMs with real-time data retrieval, allowing NPCs to generate dynamic quest dialogues that reflect the latest game development and player action. A key part of this system is the vector database, which stores high-dimension vectors from the text and other data. When an NPC receives player's query, the vector representation of the query is matched against the database to retrieve the most relevant information. This ensures NPC responses are contextually accurate and up-to-date. This will significantly enhance the immersion. If you look at the content we've built around the games, you'll find it mostly consists of unstructured documentations. To make this usable, we need to convert these documentations into embeddings before storing them into the vector database. While it's common to use tools like LangChain for generating embeddings, Redpanda Connect simplified this process significantly with Redpanda Connect. You can set everything up decoratively without needing to code. This allows us to easily build data pipeline that transform unstructured data into embedding using locally running LLMs. ensuring all data remains secure within our domain. Now let's build the pipeline with Redpanda Connect. First, Redpanda Connect reads the document file from a specific directories and process their context. Extract the text from each file and generate embedding using locally running taxonomic embedding model. These embeddings, along with the text and the file path, are then mapped and inserted into vector database. Finally, the process data is stored in a PostgreSQL table named Whispering Realm. This table includes columns for the file path, text content, and its vector representation, enabling efficient vector-based search on the stored documents. Now that our source material is ready, we can start updating our agent pipeline for both characters. First, our hero. After consuming message from the topic in the Redpanda cluster, I use a locally running language model to generate text embedding, the same model that we used earlier on to create embeddings for our vector database. With these embeddings, I then search the Whispering Realm table in our PostgreSQL database to find the three most similar documents. Using these results as context, I generated a response with another locally running language model, Llama 3.1, with the original question combining the retrieval search results. It forms the basis of the prompt. Finally, the LLM generated response was sent back to the RPG response topic, and we're done. For the MPC2, we'll follow similar process, but instead of using locally running model, we'll send the request to OpenAI for generating the response. Let's jump back into the game and ask a few story-related questions. Watch closely. Let's start with, tell me more about the realm. What do you know about the Fiend King? And just like that, the characters are now sharing detailed stories and histories about the world. It's amazing how the NPC bring the game lore to life, creating a richer, more immersive experience for the player. Last but not least, let's talk about expanding the game. For our next feature, every interaction with NPCs will now increase one of players' character abilities. Different NPCs will boost different types of abilities, encouraging players to engage more with the game's world. The addition will motivate players to seek out and converse with the NPCs, which in turn deepen their connection with the games. Event-driven architecture make implementing these features really easy, as the new services can be plugged in without interfering with the existing components. These flexibilities allow us to quickly add and integrate new features quickly. Implementing this with Redpanda Connect is also pretty straightforward. We'll set up a pipeline using Bloodline to generate random bonuses point for the player character based on their interaction with different NPCs. For our hero character, it will randomly select abilities like Courage, Strength, or Health Points, HP, and assign the bonuses between 1 to 5 points. Similar to NPC2, our Sorcerer, it chooses between Agility, Wisdom, and Magic Power, MP, with the same range of bonuses. If you happen to use different characters, we'll just subtract one from its luck abilities. The process message are then sent to the bonus topic, which will then render in the front end. And there you have it. With Redpanda Connect, we not only enhance NPC interactions, but also added a dynamic system that rewards players for engaging with the game world. From building immersive dialogues to boosting character abilities, we created a richer, more interactive game experience with just a few easy-to-configure pipelines. By leveraging event-driven architecture and powerful tools like Redpanda Connect, the possibilities are endless. And that's all I have for today. The adventure is just the beginning. Let's make it epic! Happy streaming!